Hello everyone, Ted Dale, Star Wars Nerd here. I hope you're doing well, and I want to thank you for joining me today, because we have another comic to look at today from Auditect and his crew. They are doing the comic dub of Bounty Hunter Aurra Sing. Now, I've really liked Aurra in the last Outlander series I would just watch from Auditect, and it was just awesome. The voice actress did a great job on it, and Dark Horse Comics writes a great comic, and it's just put them together, it's just greatness all together. So anyway, I have Aurra Sing set up over here. There it is. Set up and ready to go. So let's just get to it. Aurra Sing, Bounty Hunter from Auditect and his crew doing the 1998 Star Wars Dark Horse Comics. Let's get to it.
The second moon of the planet Endor. Also sometimes called the Forest Moon. Sometimes even Endor. That is, when it's called anything. Just an insignificant green rock, orbiting a lifeless, vaporous giant. Lost. Small. A child circling a dead parent. Why did we have to meet here?
I know you're here, Bounty Hunter. Please, show yourself.
You're good. For a priestess. And a blind priestess at that.
Ooh, she's awesome.
I am a daughter of the Ffib. The Order has taught me that there are many ways for one to obtain vision. I see and feel things that others can't.
True. Can you see your future? Or feel my blade on your throat?
Please, Aurra Sing, don't harm me.
You're not much of a fighter. Maybe this isn't a guild trap.
Believe me, you have nothing to fear from the Ffib. We asked the Bounty Hunters Guild to contact you. Even though you've refused to join them, we knew that Guildmaster Kratos would know how to find you.
That old Trandoshan? Only when I allow him to. I've done some jobs for him. Sometimes a hunter breaks guild law. Somebody has to go after him. Has to be an independent tracker. Someone not tied to guild factions. Me. I bring back the mark. Usually.
Then sometimes you fail.
No. Sometimes I kill them. Now why are we here? Worthless little moon. It isn't even on the charts.
The long
this
fingers
must
of hers.
Be kept secret, Aurra Sing. Because Endor is the Ffib's most remote mission, I was chosen to deliver the High Elder's request. I've only been here for a short time, and I don't expect to stay much longer. The High Elders think that the beings here can be brought into the light of our order. So far, none have come. I don't think that any will.
Ewoks!
Still, my time here is valuable. I've had time to reflect on the errors of my past, and what I must do to erase my transgressions. Every creature deserves a chance of redemption, don't you think?
Some, maybe. Not all. Why did you have me summoned?
Your specialties aren't limited to tracking guild code breakers, Aurra Sing. You wear a lightsaber. I felt it against my back when you attacked me. I thought only the Jedi possessed
such
weapons.
Knife, gun.
Sometimes they lose them. The circumstances are often quite tragic.
The stories are true, then. You've killed Jedi.
When it needs to be done. And sometimes when it doesn't.
Would you like to hunt another?
As you said, Priestess, I have my specialties. Who is this Jedi? Why have the Ffib marked him?
You've heard of Reess Kairn.
A Twi'lek pirate. Prowls the Gamma Run. What about him?
Not long ago, Kairn raided our homeworld, Loran, and looted a temple, stealing many priceless artifacts and destroying irreplaceable texts. However, these were not the worst of Kairn's misdeeds against the Ffib. On the very steps of our great temple, he murdered four priests in cold blood.
Your sect is an autocracy. You have your own security force. Send them.
They don't have the skill. Kairn was not always a pirate, you see. For once he was a Jedi Knight. Once, a long time ago, the Jedi named Kairn returned to Ryloth to find the female who was his mate in the arms of another. Consumed by jealousy and anger, he killed them both. Fearing the Jedi justice which was sure to come, he stole a cruiser and fled to the Outer Rim. Kairn's life was shattered beyond repair. His passions had opened the door to the dark side. Feeding his rage on the potent real spice, he gathered a crew and became a pirate. For years, he preyed upon the trade ships and mines of the Middle Rim. Cairn's last known foray was his attack on our temple. Soon after, he disbanded his crew and went into hiding.
Perhaps he knew that the Ffib would not forget or forgive his violations.
To confuse his trail, he bribed two of his crewmen into assuming his identity. These men are Shido twins, brothers whose rare species is gifted with the ability to simulate the appearance of others. Cairn vowed to use his plunder to feed their families forever. However, if one of them betrayed his secret, he promised that he would feed their loved ones to wild monarchs. The bargain was sealed. The pirates fled, each to a different world. To reach Cairn, you might have to kill two other beings, Aurra Sing. You realize this?
A pity. Any clues where they went?
Unknown to Reess, his cabin servant stole a look at the villain's charts, knowing someone would pay well enough for such knowledge.
Was this information rewarded?
Yes. The Ffib Inquisitor saw to that. He was compensated as only a pirate can be. Poor creature. Within his data pad are the locations of three planets, each one representing one of the states of matter: liquid, flame, and sky. Reese Cairn is on one of these worlds. Will you apprehend him for us, Aurra Sing?
I never promise to apprehend anyone, Priestess. I only guarantee one thing, that I can kill him. Live capture is harder, more overhead. It'll cost you.
Yeah.
I'll mention it to the finance committee. Remember, Bounty Hunter, the Shido are master mimics. However, there is at least one thing they cannot duplicate. Reese's eyes. The red eyes of a Twi'lek spice addict can never be hidden, Aurra Sing.
That's pretty cool.
Hoth,
pretty good so far.
At least it was once. Sixth world of the Hoth system, sometimes called the Ice Planet. Sure, obviously. Another really nice place to visit.
Like he's got some blaster wounds on him. This is kind of cool. Seeing the Wampas go in their caves. Wampas have electricity?
So, finally return without dinner, have you? About
time.
While you were outside cavorting in the snow, I've been stuck in this ice-bound wormhole extracting spice from this lonely lichen. No matter.
He's controlling them somehow.
Now, when the spice tanks are finally full, I'm off to the smuggling dens of Peridon's folly to claim my fortune. Quickly, take the meat to the kitchens. I need you to scrape while I empty the bins. You, the little one, go and skin that tauntaun the way I showed you. And remember to tidy up when you're done.
He's got those wampas Wait, under control if they can do that.
You need your biosim implants adjusted. Get to the kitchen. Yep. Now.
Huh. Interesting.
Sorry. I don't do dishes.
Oh, hell. She's
and
hiding
no
inside.
No one likes my cooking.
Nice.
Aurra Sing, you won't take me alive.
Fair enough. Saves the Ffib a lot of money.
Oh, she's got a jetpack. Did not know that. Cool.
Red orb biocomputer in my head buzzing. Calls this thing a dragon slug. The cave that I caused awakened it. Almost there. I can see daylight.
Nice.
All right. Let's get a look. One of the She-Edo. It figures. Two to go.
Nice.
Tatooine, Flame. Tattoo System, the Outer Rim. Township of Mos Espa. I've been here before. Hated it then, loathe it now. Not that I'm belly aching. Work's work. And I like her job.
That's cool. You're just sipping a drink.
It's the last Shi'ido. Good enough. Now only Kairn is left. What's your name, kid?
Wuher.
This Wuher? Is a tough world, Wuher. Get used to it.
That's Wuher's the what do you call it? The barkeep in the cantina in A New Hope.
Bespin, sky.
We've had liquid.
Last stop.
Flame and sky.
Yeah, that's it. More of that kind of stuff. The crowds at Coruscant will love you guys.
Nice. That would be cool. A little
put a
circus
big tour
like that.
Together. Give the investors a real nice package, you know? I promise you guys will take the galaxy by storm. No! Air brothers, hear me! That woman on the air hub wants to kill me! Help me!
What's this? More Thranta riders, armed to the teeth and painted for war. They were waiting. Someone told them I was coming.
Uh-huh. Oh! Get him, Aurra!
Ask any non-resident on Bespin, they'll tell you the same thing. Airhook or Thranta, most will pick them sheep.
Yeah.
Of course, airhooks have their drawbacks. Highly unstable fuel cells, for one. Game over. Time to collect the pieces. Let's get a look at you, just to be sure. What? A third Shi'ido. Liquid flame, sky. The Ffib left one out. Endor, land.
Ah.
The bounty hunter has probably killed all three of them by now. Was I so wrong to dupe the Shi'ido triplets, to sentence them to death so that I might be free to seek redemption? Eventually they'd have died anyway, caught and executed by the Ffib Tribunal. The arms of the Inquisitors are long. Their judgment knows no mercy. What better place to hide from the Ffib than among them, as someone whom they could never possibly suspect? No longer a pirate named Reess Kairn. No longer a Twi'lek. No longer male. Sometime after I killed those priests, the darkness lifted. I wanted only to make restitution for what I've done. In the laboratories of Balmora, I paid outlaw surgeons to fashion my vessel of atonement. To honor my beloved, I took this form. To honor the priests I killed, I took the vows of their order. In the temples on Loran, I'll disappear within the numberless horde that is my new family. Even if the Thranta mercenaries did not kill her as I paid them to do, Aurra Sing could never find me. I won't pretend that the Jedi Knights could ever forgive me, so I shall seek penance in the Ffib. Soon, the ship will be here. I'll be bound for a new life. A life of hope, redemption, peace, truth, and justice.
Oh! Took her out! Yep. That's just the end of it, yeah. Well, very cool. That was awesome. She did a great job taking them out, yeah. So, yeah. Very cool. Good job. Love that. Love that. I was kind of thinking at the beginning that that didn't actually really sound too much like a female voice actress, and that kind of confirmed at the end he's no longer male, so yeah, nice. Very cool. Very good. But good story. Good little story arc for Aurra Sing. Shows how badass she is as a bounty hunter going out and taking them all out. Skipping to land, sky, flame, air. Yeah, land, whatever. Going after all of them. And yeah. So it was a good little story. Good work from the voice actors working for Auditect. Great editing. Everything. Everything awesome as always. Good story from Dark Horse. Great sounds and stuff from Auditect. So put them together. You can't lose. That's just awesome. And I'm looking forward to doing more with him. And yeah. So come back again. We'll watch more comics. Coming up will be Emissaries of Malastare. So come back for that one. And I'm Ted, the old Star Wars nerd. Thanks for joining me. Come back again next time. We'll read some more comics. Please leave a comment below. Click that like button. Click the subscribe button. Click that bell for notifications. And until next time, take care, all right? Thanks. Hey, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. I really appreciate it. If you enjoy my videos, please click that like button. Leave a comment below and make sure you're subscribed so you can get notifications of all my future content. All of you are so great, and I want to thank each and every one of you for your support. Thanks for stopping in, and I hope to see you again real soon. Take care.